I am incredibly stoked for this new PvP content, Crystal Conflict, and we'll go over all you need to know about this and the new reward system for PvP in this video. In the Final Fantasy XIV Live Letter 67, Yoshi-P announced that we'll be getting an entirely new concept of PvP called Crystal Conflict. These will be short matches with simple rules that can be played casually. The difference is most PvP content, such as Duty Roulette, runs around 72 players, which creates a really low impact for players, in my opinion, by not giving a sense of responsibility since there are so many other players. With this new PvP mode, they'll be trying a 5v5, which is a little more on brand for any MMO's PvP aspects of the game, which allows for quicker games and hopefully lower wait times. They will be removing role-based matchmaking, tank, healer, DPS, and have actions and additional distinctive PvP actions and job-specific adrenaline rushes. With the concept that they introduced, it kind of reminds me of Overwatch's push mode, which is something similar to pushing an object into the other player's territory. In Final Fantasy's version, each team will be formed of 5 different jobs with no role restrictions. I think here they really want to emphasize that you don't need the traditional healer role, tank role, or DPS role. It could be any job in Final Fantasy XIV. And they will have casual matches, ranked matches, and custom matches available by skill-based matchmaking. Teams will fight for possession of the crystal. Once you claim possession of the crystal, which I am guessing is through the initial and subsequent battles, the crystal will begin moving to the opponent's side. Once you push the crystal into the other player's base, that team will win. I am excited to see how they'll execute this for Final Fantasy XIV. This just seems like a simple tug of war type of game style and is usually pretty successful in most MMOs. Not only that, is they will also have mechanics or gimmicks that they will incorporate into the PvP mode Crystal Conflict, with this photo right here demonstrating that. I don't know about you guys, but this totally screams Bomberman bomb explosions to me, which I'm totally here for, which they even mentioned in the live stream that being on the Hudson teams and working on Bomber was not the inspiration for this, which is obviously heavy sarcasm on their part. I think this is genius, and I'm hoping for a very successful launch with this new mode. Let's go over the reward system that they'll be using for this and some other unexpected changes that I didn't see coming that they made. They will have season rewards, ranking rewards, and tier rewards. You'll also be able to get titles, achievements, and other things. The specific season is going to be related to Crystal Conflict specifically. They will be doing an entire overhaul on the PvP reward systems, which will be tentatively called series, which will be separate as seasons. So series is going to be a complete separate timelines as the seasons. Series will also have rewards by participating in any PvP content in Final Fantasy XIV. So from what I can gather, series will be for all PvP content, and Crystal Conflict will have its own season as well, but the series will be longer. So maybe we'll have 2 or 3 seasons in one series. This can be changed though, and it's a little convoluted, but we'll know more as we get closer. Within the series, players can accumulate series experience and raise the series level. So almost like a badge pass or a series pass that reminds me a little bit of Destiny's 2 seasons pass. It's basically a way to track your level within the series, and you can get a multitude of rewards as you level up pass. When you reach new levels, it looks like we'll be receiving a token as a currency. They will also have gear mounts and other items tied to your series level. You guys, this is really exciting stuff in my personal opinion. They're basically changing the system to play PvP in your own manner and be able to move at your own pace. When the series changes to series 2, it looks like you will reset to level 1 and the rewards will change as well. I'm super interested on what type of rewards they're going to have, if they will recycle some of the PvP rewards we can get now, or will it be based on theme or what? It also looks like once you get tokens, they will carry on to the next series, which is great. So a way to carry over the time you put in to one series to another. And previous series rewards will be available eventually by this token exchange. If you already aren't doing PvP, this is a pretty good reason to start adding this into your weekly rotation of duties, amongst the million of other things we also have to do every week. But I will say, because the series are going to be so long, let's say between 6.1 and 6.2, we're going to have time to do these things and we won't have to feel rushed if it's going to change every week or every 2 weeks. It looks like it's going to be a longer time frame, maybe a few months. All in all, seems like they really thought this out, and I'll be diving into this more and updating you with more videos on this in the future. Let me know what you guys think about this new mode down below, and if you've gotten any value so far, then don't forget to limit break 3 that subscribe button down below. A few other updates is that we will be stopping the feast, which is the regular PvP seasons that they have going on right now. You will be able to play the preseason that happens in 6.0 when that drops, but after that they will be stopping the feast as of right now. They didn't necessarily say indefinitely, but they just said unavailable. I think they just really want to focus on the new crystal PvP as their main source of fun and entertainment. They will be adjusting the achievements just so then you can still obtain them. Wolf collars will still be obtainable and tradable in other manners, so don't discard these items if you have some. They are also introducing a profile system which allows you to customize these kind of cards that will have fancy backgrounds and stats and additional information. A lot of other MMOs have these already, so it's pretty cool that they're fine-tuning some of the MMO aspects that really allow for even more community and knowledge exchange. These changes to PvP are really going to balance out my personal time that I put in, and I usually like to blow off steam with some quick consumable content, so I'm really looking forward to this new PvP mode, Crystal Conflict. I wanted to cover the live letter in 3 different videos so you can choose what you want to watch and what you're most interested in. If you want to see the crafter and gatherer changes or the job role and role quest changes, you can click on the videos at the end of this video. I wanted to give a huge thank you to my Patreon supporters, as your continued support really allow me to keep making videos on this channel. If you'd like to support this channel's content, then you can click on the Linktree description down below to find all that information, as well as my public Discord. If you want to watch the other 2 Final Fantasy Live Letter videos, then you can click here.